Now we would be learning about a science topic called chemical reaction. I'm sure you have learned about different chemicals in your previous classes and have some basic information about it. But today we will be learning more. You must be thinking it's a very difficult topic. But chemical reactions are everywhere, even in your home environment. What happens to the milk if you keep it overnight? What happens to the food if you keep it for a long time? How does it get spoiled? What happens to the atta if you keep it for a long time? What is happening when you remove the nail polish? All these are examples of chemical change. You can see it all around you in your home. I want to give you two more examples. That's metal, iron rod. And what has happened to it? It's become rusted. With rain and wind and moisture, the color has changed. That is a chemical reaction. If you keep the iron rod in contact with air and moisture, it changes. It rusts. On the left-hand side, you can see iron, and on the right-hand side, you see rusted iron. Another example is coal. What happens when you burn coal? That's also a chemical reaction. In that reaction, a new gas called carbon dioxide comes out. Now you have seen the two examples, but I think I'll show you three more activities so that you know what happens in a chemical reaction. That's activity one. As all of you can see, that's a magnesium ribbon. It's one kind of metal. And that's the fire. When you start burning magnesium ribbon, it changes into ash. So what's really happening? It's changing. When you burn magnesium, the structure of magnesium changes from solid form to ash. Now see activity two. That's lead nitrate. It's one kind of chemical. Another chemical, potassium iodide. When you add potassium iodide to lead nitrate, it changes into lead iodide. When you mix those two chemicals, the color change happens. And that's a chemical reaction. Now see activity three. Those are zinc granules. When you add sulfuric acid to zinc granule, and please be careful when you add this acid, it can damage your skin. After you add sulfuric acid to zinc, it changes into zinc chloride plus a chemical reaction occurs and hydrogen gas is emitted. So what really happens in a chemical reaction? There is a change in heat, color, the physical structure. All this is part of chemical reaction.